What's up, Grio fam? I'm your host, Nayo Campbell, and welcome to the Grio Top 3, where we count down the top 3 trending stories of the day. And coming in at number 3, MSNBC host Tiffany Cross gives Meghan McCain the read of a lifetime, saying that she should definitely lose her job. Cross referenced a recent episode on The View in which McCain criticized senators Tammy Duckworth and Mazie Hirono, who threatened to pull their support from the administration of President Joe Biden for its exclusion of senior Asian American voices. At this point, responding to this news, co-host of The View, Meghan McCain, said, "We've only had one Asian American host co-host this show. So does that mean one of us should be leaving at some point because there's not enough representation?" And well, Tiffany Cross responded saying, "Yes. One of you should definitely lose your job. I'll give you 2 guesses, but you'll only need one." Drops mic. Well, she actually said a lot more, detailing and schooling Meghan on identity politics. You can watch some of the video here, but you can also check the full video out on Tiffany Cross's Instagram.
Yes, one of you should definitely lose your job. I'll give you 2 guesses, but you'll only need one. So first, not sure if you guys know this or not, because she's really shy about bringing it up, but Meghan happens to be the daughter of the late Republican Senator John McCain, but don't tell anyone because obviously she'd never want to bring that up every 5 minutes in lieu of having actual intellectual exchange. But yes, let's talk identity politics. Feminist writer Barbara Smith was among the 3 women who coined the term identity politics, and the original intent of the phrase was articulating Black women's struggle at the nexus of race, gender, and class oppressions. But just like with hairstyles, Meghan, we've watched you take it, twist it, braid it, and lock it so it benefits the warped presentation of your own clumsy and ill-informed thoughts.
Woo child, that was definitely an old school read by Tiffany Cross. And coming in at number 2, Black Twitter and, well, social media reacts to Chet Hanks' white boy summer. Now you guys, Chet Hanks is the son of the famous Tom Hanks. And Chet has gone viral quite a few times for some of his comments and antics. In an Instagram video, the 30-year-old proudly proclaimed that white boy summer is coming soon and told his followers to get ready. Now, he did say it's not like that Donald Trump white boy. It's more like the, let me read exactly what he said. "I just got this feeling, man. This is summer about to be white boy summer, you know. Take it how you want. I'm not talking like Donald Trump, NASCAR type white. I'm talking about me, John B., Jack Harlow type white boys. So let me know if you guys can vibe with that and get ready, because I am." Well, of course, Black Twitter had a lot to say. Now, some people laughing at the video and just, you know, responding back with jokes. While singer and host Jesse Wu said, "John B. somewhere minding his business, singing about what they don't know." She then later reacted to his caption that said, "Tag a real Vanilla King." And she said, "Tag a what?" After Laz Alonso simply said, "Nah." These are some of the other Twitter reactions.
"Hey guys, look, I just wanted to tap in really quick. I just got this feeling, man, that this summer is, it's about to be a white boy summer. You know, take it how you want."
All right, and coming in at number 1, Nike denies role in Lil Nas X's Satan shoes containing human blood. He will be releasing 666 pairs of his promotional sneakers, which are modified Nike Air Max 97s, and they're set to go on sale for $1,018 each. The shoes are actually supposed to be released today. Now, Nike has released a statement saying, "We do not have a relationship with Lil Nas X or MSCHF, which is the brand that's partnering with Lil Nas X." They said, "Nike did not design or release these shoes and we do not endorse them." Now, Lil Nas X has caused quite a stir on social media for his latest video, Montero. Y'all gotta go and check it out. In his response to both the shoes and the video, he said, "This was simply the agenda to make people stay the F out of other people's lives and stop dictating who they should be. Sending you love from the future." Now, the response was actually a letter that he wrote to his younger self. All right, Grio fam, this has been the Grio Top 3. I'm your host, Nayo Campbell. Make sure you guys head over to youtube.com/TheGrio for more videos like this. And also be sure to check out TheGrio.com. Thank you guys so much for watching.